Good morning all. Welcome to our chemistry online class of Sri Gokulam Public School Guruvayur. Myself Rakhi Radhakrishnan and I am your chemistry faculty. So in the last class we discussed about what is crystal field theory and how does crystal field splitting take place for tetrahedral and octahedral complexes. We also studied about the limitations of CFT. Now today we are going to discuss about the bonding in metal carbonyls. So let's enter into our session. Good morning students. Today we are going to introduce a new topic, that is bonding in metal carbonyls. So in the last class we discussed about the crystal field theory, its limitation and how the crystal field splitting take place in octahedral complex and tetrahedral complexes, and also discuss about some variations of color happen in some metal complexes. So today we are going to discuss about the bonding in metal carbonyls. Metal carbonyls means a metal that is attached with a carbonyl ligand, which means CO ligand. Look here, there are two kinds of metal carbonyl bondings take place. Since CO bond is ketone bond, which is triple bond like this, so metal is attached with the carbon with a triple bond of oxygen. And there are two types of donation take place, where the carbonyl ligand donate the electron to the metal, and also the metal donate the electrons to the vacant d orbital of carbonyl ligand. So carbonyl to metal donation has also take place, and metal to carbonyl, that means back donation, is also take place here. So this is the resonance structure of metal carbonyl bond. So we know that when minus charge comes on this side, what happened? It become double bond C, and when this triple bond is transferred this side, what happened? It got four lone pairs of electron and become M double bond C double bond O. This is the resonance structure of metal carbonyl bond. Now looking at the MO theory, based on MO theory we can split it into different energy level, carbon and oxygen, where both are sp hybridization, so one electrons for each, so it gets splitted into sigma electron, pi electron and sigma star pz electron, then pi star. Above this level, this is antibonding and this level is bonding molecular orbital. So there, in metal carbonyl bond, there are two types of characters are shown. One is sigma character and another one is pi character. So this is sigma character and this is pi character. So sigma character is formed by donating the lone pair of electrons from carbonyl bond to the vacant orbital of the metal atom. So C orbital consists of lone pairs of electron. It donate these lone pair of electron to the vacant orbital of metal orbital. So sigma donation happen there. But in case of pi back donation, what happens is the filled orbital, the filled d orbital of metal atom. Metal atom consists of d orbital, and the filled d orbital donate its electron to the antibonding, to the antibonding vacant orbital of carbonyl ligand. Okay, that is pi star. Here pi star is antibonding orbital. It is empty, and dx orbital, the completely filled electrons, is transferred to this carbonyl ligand. So this is why the pi bond exists, or the pi character exists. And this sigma donation and pi back donation is togetherly known by a name, that is synergic effect. So the metal to ligand bond create a synergic effect, that affect the strengthening of metal and carbonyl bond. So, look here, there are various kinds of metal carbonyl bond we have to study. First one is metal with attached with carbonyl ligand. Two metals are attached with carbonyl, three metals are attached and two metals are attached with carbonyl ligand. There are many types of carbonyl compounds. For example, mononuclear carbonyl compounds, which means one metal atom and three other carbonyl atoms are attached. For example, NiCO4, FeCO5, only one metal atom is there present. In binuclear, there are two metal atoms are present. For example, CO2, CO8, we can say Mn2, CO10. These are the example. And FeSCO9, M2CO10, these are the example. It also show polynuclear where there are more than two metal atoms present, like Fe3CO12, okay, and M6CO16. These are the representation of polynuclear carbonyl compound. So what is meant by metal carbonyl bond? Means metal carbonyl bond, there are two types of bonding take place, sigma bond and pi bond. In sigma bond, what happen is there the filled d orbital or the lone pairs of electron from the carbonyl bond donates its electron to the unfilled metal orbital. That's why the sigma bond is formed. And in pi bond formation, what happen is there the filled d orbital of metal atom donates its electron to the antibonding orbital of carbonyl ligand, and this back donation creates a synergic effect which strengthens the metal carbonyl bond. So now you get the concept of what is carbonyl compound, what are the bonding take place in carbonyl compound. So let's conclude this session. The related link and the note is attached along with this video. Go through the link and download the notes, and don't forget to attend the test paper. So I'm winding this section. See you in the next class. Till then, take care. Bye.